Hi, this is Susan, and welcome to Zoho Quick Tips. One of the ways that you can really make your life easier, as well as that of your sales team, is to create really great email templates that they can use for quick replies. Email templates can also be used in some of your drip campaigns. Let's look at how you would do that in Zoho CRM. When sending an email to any record in your database, you usually have two options. I can click the default email address, which will automatically open up whatever your default email provider is. I use Google Apps, but if you're using Outlook, it should open up a new message window from Outlook. There's an alternate button at the top which says Send Email. When you click that, it opens up the Zoho email window, which gives you the option to choose a template in order to send something. Email templates can be designed for almost every module, and they're created to send a common message to one or more recipients, and it can include merged personal details in each of the email sends. For example, let me just choose a template. I have an example of, let's say, a meetup parking, so where it replaced a merge field with the record's first name. But you can choose other templates as well, and today I want to talk about how to create those templates. You'll start by clicking on Tools. And under customization, there is templates. Notice that the default is email, but you can have other kinds of templates as well, inventory and mail merge templates. They all work pretty much the same way. When you're ready to create a new template, you will have to always select the module that you will create the template for. Sometimes that's a little bit more frustrating because you may have the same template that you would want to send to leads and contacts, in which case you just have to create the template twice, one for the leads module, one for the contacts module. But when you create it, you'll select the module and click Next. And then you'll select a basic template type. But I want to go back for a second to show you some options. I have three templates right here called thank you templates. And I want to show you what the three look like. You might pick this kind of template, which has more of a graphical look. You can have corporate header, you can have images, you can have buttons that do things, and it will be centered in the middle of the page with some kind of color around the outside when it sends. There is another kind of template called the blank template. Notice, by the way, that when you pick this one, it is also centered inside and it has gray around it. The third template looks more like what I would call an email template that came straight out of your normal email provider. I want to show you where those templates are. So let me go back and create a new template. And I'm going to create one for contacts and create next. So each of those three templates were determined by which button you picked here, which option you picked here. I'm going to move this over to the side for a second. If you want the one that looks like it came from an email from your email provider, just like you just send it out of your email package, you pick this one, which is not what most people would think. Most people would think you would pick the blank one, but the blank one is going to create an email that is centered on the page and by default has a gray outline. You can change it to white, but it's still going to be centered. It's not going to be left justified like this option would be. And then you can pick one of the pre-formatted templates where you can, it kind of guides you in inserting graphics in different locations. Regardless of which one you pick, it doesn't, you know, you can say, I could say pick this one and say select it, and it will give me options to pull over text and drop it in, or it would give me an option to pull over an image and drop it in. It's very easy to do, but I'm going to back up because I don't want to create that kind. Most of my templates that I do are created using this button right here. This is my favorite one for sending out templates that don't look like promotional templates. They don't have a lot of graphics, if any. They really look like you just sent it straight to the customer. And for me, that's the kind of email that I want to to send. So I'm developing a personal relationship. So I pick that one. A lot of times people don't pick it because it says HTML and it makes them kind of nervous. But don't worry about it because it just means I have a toolbar like this that will allow me to do all kinds of things. I can change my font. I can change the font size. I can make it bold, italic, underline. I can change the background color or the font color, the justification, bullets. You can see all of the different options that I have. Here's where I would put in a graphic. You put in a table, put in a line. There's all kinds of ways that you can customize the template. Usually when you're creating a template, you're going to start off with the person's first name and say something. I know sometimes people like to say hi. I don't. I just like to start off with the person's first name because that's how I would do it normally if I was emailing you. So down at the bottom, it'll say there's a hint that says to insert a merge field type a pound and choose one from the list. So up here, I'm just going to type a pound. And then I have all of these options of fields. Whatever field you have in your database, it's there. But I also have other things that are related, like account. Maybe I want to put in, I notice that you're in the industry of, and then I could go put in an industry field. Or so anything that's related, I could easily pop that in. But in this case, what I want to type in first name. So I'm just going to start typing the name of the field that I know, which is first. And as soon as I see it, I'm going to click first name. Then you can put a comma in. Sometimes I don't put a comma in, mostly because I don't do it in my email templates, but also in case there are situations in your database where the first name field did not get filled in because you copied the first name into the last name field. I don't want to start an email with a blank field and a comma. It's very obvious that it's an automated message of some kind. So I'm just going to press enter. Now at this point, I can just type whatever I want, press enter, you know, do different things. I can add bullets, you know, do this. And then I'm finished with the bullets, so I'm going to click it again. It works just like any word processor would work. You can add other fields. You know, as I said, I see you are in the, and then I'm just going to type in industry field. Or I could say your company name is, or whatever it is, your contract will be ending on, and then you'll fill in the contract end date. And whatever it is you want to type, just fill in as you would normally. And I'm just going to, but at the end, what I want to do is add a signature, a user signature, so that I want to create this template so that anybody in my organization can use it. Now, I could just manually type in my signature if I wanted to, but that makes it so that other people can't use it. So there is a merge field called signature. If I start to type signature, notice there is a user signature. So whoever is the record owner, it will fill in that signature, or whoever's logged in, it will fill in, it's whoever's logged in will fill in that signature on the email when it's sent. Now, I would click save, but I know it's not going to work because it says, wait, you haven't given it a name. So up here at the top, there are two name fields. One is the template name, so that's just going to be a generic name. I'll just say, thank you, demo. And here is the subject. So what do you want the subject to be when the person sees the email? So I'm just going to say, thank you, something like that. Now I'm ready to click save. And it says, which folder would you like to put it in? There are a couple of reasons for folders. I keep them in public, generally, if I want it to be shared. Sometimes if you have a ton of email templates, like we do, you'll want to separate them into different folders in order to make it easier to find certain things. Another reason for folders, which I won't go into right now, but you can use a folder for, let's say, one salesperson. Let's say one salesperson really likes to create templates, but they're not really approved by the company. So you could create a folder just for that person so they don't get mixed in with everybody else's stuff. So I'm going to click save. Notice it brought me back out to here. So now I can go back to Bill and I can send email and choose a template. I can choose the thank you demo. Notice it just pops right in and it filled in my name. It could I could choose the thank you with the graphics, or I can choose the template that is the thank you that's the blank. Notice how that's going to go. Remember how I said it's blank. It's going to have that centered look when it goes out. Or I can choose the template that was made with HTML, which is the one I like. It looks a lot more like what I would think would be a normal email template. And then when you're ready, you can send. I want to go back and modify that template. So I'm just going to go back to Tools, Templates. This is the demo. I'm going to click on this to edit it. I could copy it if I want to. They use the word clone, but I'm going to edit it because there's some other things I could do. I can make some words bold. I could add some things. I could add something that has a link. But in our case, add an attachment, because there are many times when you'll want to add an attachment that just goes out as standard. So in my case, I want to add a W-9 because a lot of times people ask me for a W-9. It's just a constant thing. So that way I can have it so that it's always pre-added to the template that I'm sending. Whenever you have made a change, it's always going to ask you to add comments for the version. This is more for keeping track of, as you make changes, do you have more people that open it or read it? In this case, it's really just a valid change, and I'm not trying to track if one subject line or one text is better than another. So I'm just going to, I just type in X and click done, because that's, I really don't care. I'm not trying to keep track of it. Notice that in this case, I've got two that have gone out, but I can see the different statistics of the templates that go out and how often they're open. Let's look at this. No, I don't think I did that one, but you can see the click rate and the version, and by version you can see, was there one version that was opened more than others? Two thoughts as I leave you. One is, if you want to copy a template from another platform, let's say like Word, you can paste something in. Say, for instance, let me just paste in some of my script here. Let me edit and paste it in. Sometimes it's a good idea to use this plain text right here to take out anything that any extra formatting that might have been included in Word. So I'm just going to click the plain text. It strips everything, and then go back to rich text. So even though it may take a little extra work in order for me to clean it up, I know that it's, when I send it, it's not going to have a lot of extra formatting that will make it look really ugly. And also, in all of these templates, if you think that someone might want to, like a user might want to add something additional to before sending the template, for example, if I go back to Bill and I decide to send an email, let's say I might pick the one of the thank you templates. And if you think that your end user is going to say, thanks for the call, or add something before they click the send button, because it is possible to do that, you'll want to be sure and not use any fonts. Try not to use the font button here or the typeface or the font size, because that way it'll keep, if someone's email package is somewhat different, it'll keep the fonts from changing size on you before you send the template. Certainly when creating the more graphical templates, which look like this, let me go ahead and edit. There are lots of options and things that you can use. You'll look at the components over here. I don't use these very often, but if you want to, it's not that difficult. The only thing to keep in mind that as you add things, like this is a graphic, you can control a lot of the things by using the toolbar up here that changes. So I could say, make that a large, it kind of changes the size of the graphic. I can make it small. Same thing for this one. I can change it to a smaller graphic if I want to. Even in here, notice when I click in the text, you have the same toolbar that you had when you just picked the plain HTML template. This is a nice toolbar over here at the left if you want to put in things that are like columns. So there I picked one that has a text on two sides. This is a three column and a graphic in the middle, and I can move this around just by dragging and dropping. All of these things are real easy to use. You might have to kind of play with a little bit, but you can get some pretty elaborate templates if you like. Notice this is a column template. I can switch it to two columns, or I can change the sizing of the columns, you know, to something like that if you want to, just by clicking on your toolbar options up here at the top. One of the last things I wanted to mention that you can do with templates is that you can use them to make smaller sends. It's not like the Zoho campaigns where you can send thousands at one time. But in this case, I have a smaller set of 22 records that are selected. And notice that when I just select all of the records, or just select, let's say, specific ones, that I can click the send email button. And from here, I can select the template, and I can do that thank you demo template that I did just now. I can determine who to send it from. If I pick this option, it'll send it from whoever is the record owner. That's where that user signature is very handy. Or I could use a organization email. That's another topic, but you can go look it up if you like. In this case, I just want to send it for myself. I can send it immediately, or I can schedule it for a later time. Let's say if I'm doing this the night before, I might want to do it tomorrow morning at a reasonable time. I can schedule follow-up actions, like if the email is opened, update a field, or add a follow-up. You can see it's actually pretty cool, some of the things you can do. I'm going to say done because I don't really want to trigger an action, but I can schedule follow-up actions. Once I'm finished, I just want to click send, and it will be automatically sent to my selected people. Now, in this case, I can't add any text before it gets sent out, but you get the idea. Thanks for watching. If you found this tip helpful, be sure to give it a thumbs up, and you should also subscribe to my channel if you want to be notified when I upload more tips. As always, if you need help in using or customizing your own Zoho CRM, or creating templates for your own email campaigns, or even in training your team and how to use them, give us a shout. You can find our contact info in the information box below.